So what is the ClickBank marketplace? There's a lot out there in the general marketplace, right, of the internet marketing world, and confusion around what is gravity and like rank and what all these kind of things. We're going to demystify that for you right now, cover what the marketplace actually is and how you can best use it to find the best offers to promote for your traffic. Let's dive in. Okay, so like the name implies, the marketplace is where all the offers and products listed on ClickBank are found. Now, while customers can go there to actually buy a product, the better use case and how it's more designed is for affiliates to find an offer to promote. So the idea of the marketplace is kind of like a search engine, like Google, if you will, but where affiliates are going to search for offers that align with traffic they might have, or if they're, you know, a big scaled affiliate or something like that who has, you know, they could promote anything, the top converting offers for those types of traffic. So that is inherently what it is. The confusion often stems from like terms like gravity, which you should check out the gravity video we did specifically for that. We can link to that in the description below. But essentially, gravity is a proprietary name, an algorithm that ClickBank has to help rank these offers in a way that tells an affiliate other offers other affiliates are having success selling this product. So similar to backlinks in Google being a big ranking factor, the number of affiliates getting sales to an offer is a big part of what gravity ranks. It's not the only thing, but it's probably the most influential thing, if that makes sense. So that's inherently what it is, but let's dive into a ClickBank account here and really cover like best ways to use it and kind of how to optimize and find the best offers for your traffic. So let's dive in. So I'm in here in a test account. And I'm just in the main dashboard. To actually get to the marketplace, first off, you're gonna jump over just to your main header, which says marketplace here. There's a change to ClickBank, which happened months ago now, but essentially you need to be logged into your ClickBank account to actually find the marketplace. This was done mostly so we could get better data around how people are using it and then actually improve the marketplace overall. Now, once you're here, right, you can find products and search up here. What I like to do, or you can kind of drill into categories, but what I like to do is actually just hit the search button, which will just kind of stack rank based on rank. You can filter by gravity if you'd like to. Rank is more based around volume of sales versus number of affiliates, so it kind of depends on what you're most interested in. They'll give you similar results most of the time with some slight variations of the rankings. But this will stack rank the offers and products without any regard to niche, right? So just based on what happens in ranking, we'll see that there's weight loss supplements, there is, you know, dental stuff, hearing, Ted's Woodworking, there's make money online offers, Trump coin offers, right? So there's all types of offers being listed here in the overall ranking. And you can just kind of go from here and get an idea what they are, but we'll just kind of cover like this example. What the marketplace is going to tell you is the average dollar per conversion that you're going to make. So the average money per conversion that you, the affiliate, looking at this is going to make. So on average, I'm going to make $131 off of promoting Okinawa Flat Belly Tonic. That seems pretty great, honestly. I can click promote to generate a hop link or a tracking link to use in my promotions, actually get credit for those sales. And just want to highlight, a conversion here is essentially a customer. Right, so when a customer checks out and goes through the upsell process and initial buy process, I'm gonna make $131 on average for that customer. And that's essentially what that's telling me. So initial through any upsells that are happening. I can get more details on what the offer is here. If there's an affiliate page linked to, I can check it out here. This used to be called the affiliate tools page, but we found that calling it a tools page, letting people to just put like a boring swipe file up there or something. And we wanted people to really put more details around these offers. So the affiliate page is where you can get more resources like swipe files, but also learn more about what the offer is and just what this like 140 characters can tell you. If they include affiliate support details here, you can get them here. So I know I can email this and talk to their affiliate manager if I have any questions. And that's, I'm assuming it's probably gonna be listed on their affiliate page too. If I want to, I can add this to my favorites, if it's something I want to come back to and check out, which then you'd find in your favorites tab over here. So you can start to kind of click so you don't lose things. You can kind of add to favorites. You can always delete them later if you want to go back and review. If you're just kind of scanning through, it's kind of how I like to use it. And then down here, you're going to get some additional stats, right? This is usually the biggest one, average dollar per conversion, that people are worried about. But here we'll break it down further. So it'll tell you if there's what the average initial dollar per conversion is, which you can see here, this is the same, which means there's probably no recurring, because the next stat here is the recurring dollars per rebill I'm going to get for this offer. So they don't have any rebills. That's fine. A lot don't. It'll list their gravity. Again, gravity is kind of arbitrary. It's just saying that, right, this gravity is 447, this one's 427. That's why it's ranking above this one. It doesn't mean, a lot of people think that means there's 447 affiliates promoting it. That's not what that means. It just means that there's probably more affiliates promoting it than custom keto diet right now. And that's why it's higher. And it'll list the category. And if I had been an affiliate for this and generated some clicks and sales for it, it would actually take all these same stats but apply it to my traffic here. So it'd tell me what my actual initial dollars per conversion is, what my recurring dollars per rebill is, and things like that in this, my stats section, things like refunds and chargebacks too, down there too. So you can kind of get a glance, if you've actually promoted before, how it's going versus your ClickBank analytics information. Now, we know kind of what's in here. These little tabs below will kind of just give you some basic insights into like what they have. So this means that there is like an upsell flow. This means it's mobile optimized, which almost every site is now based on custom, you know, web browsers or the site changing, things like that. I don't honestly use these icons too much. They're basically just referring to items here on the sidebar, which is where you can kind of be a power user when it comes to the marketplace. So here is where you can start to filter things down. I don't like to search by keyword too much, just because I feel like I miss things more than I want to. So I will search things down. I'll go into a niche, for example, and I'll filter down by these filters here. So if you want to set, say, let's say you want to see things that don't have a zero gravity, you want to say it has a minimum of 20. And you'll find as you mess with this and go in different niches, this changes quite a bit for different niches. Like 20 might be actually fairly high for a smaller niche, but as we see here, fairly low for others. And let's say I want to filter this down to like middle performers. So I want to see things between 20 and 100 or something. So now I can get an idea of like what's getting decent traction, but not super blown up, because maybe I don't want to compete with the top offers or top affiliates as much. Like Piano for All's here, for example. I know that's a great offer. I think we covered it in a top offers video before. Backyard Revolution, that's another great offer, right? So I know some of these offers personally, just by my time here at ClickBank, Cedar Burn too. So there's some great offers in here just filtering down that I'm getting past like the really top offers, which I might be hitting more competition on when I'm trying to promote. And then let's say I know that I need to make a minimum of $50 per sale, right? I could actually drag this initial dollars per conversion up to that 50 range. You can just type it in too. That would actually be easier. and go, okay, so now I'm filtering down to products that will only pay me more than $50, right? $50.14, Water Freedom System. Another good offer, right? I know that one. So I can start to back into my earning and traffic needs a bit here. Same with recurring. A lot of affiliates, you know, most affiliates don't care about recurring too much. They just want to make the most money they can up front. But some people really like it. So maybe you know that I want to make $10 for every rebill minimum. So this will, if I adjust this though, you'll notice that it just kind of killed any offer without recurring. So be mindful of that. You might miss some things if you're not aware of that. So now I'm seeing offers that will give me $50 initial conversions and at least $10 in recurring on average. So I can start to build in decent upfront with some long tail earnings of commission. I'll reset that back down so I'm not filtering things too much. This date added to marketplace is a really interesting field that people use pretty creatively, right? Sometimes affiliates like to just see all the new offers that are popping up. So they might just filter this to see like yesterday's or last week's or last month's, whenever they last looked at it. This is a great way to see like fresh offers, if you will. So let's say I'll look at, you know, the last quarter or so of 2021. and then, right, I have some other filters in here, so it's kind of going to adjust some things. But now I'll get an idea of who's added offers to this, to the marketplace roughly this year. And right out the gate, I'm seeing some really good ones. It's still stacking based on gravity. BioFit has been scaling big. Trump coins have been selling a lot. Divine Locks is a great offer, right? But I'm starting to see new offers to the marketplace this year versus ones that might have been around for the last 9 months or so. So I'm starting to get like fresher offers, if you will. And then same kind of thing, time frame for my stats. This will actually just adjust the My Stats section here and show you. So if you want to filter down, like, how do these offers do? If you've been promoting a bunch of them for the last month, you could filter this time frame for My Stats down here. Then you're going to more attributes after this. So if you wanted to say sell supplements or physical products only, you didn't want to exclude all the digital, you can just click on physical here, and this will filter back to only those supplements or anything with a physical shipping component to it. The next part would be if you want to make sure they have upsells. Honestly, most of them will. You might as well include it and check upsells and make sure that you're promoting something with a fully fleshed out offer. Just be mindful, this might remove some higher ticket options, right? If there's like a $2,000 course in the make money niche or something, sometimes those don't have upsells to them. So just be mindful that checking this all the time might reduce some visibility into those types of offers. But if you don't want to mess with them, if that's not part of your niche, don't worry about it. Obviously required languages, if they have support for any of these languages, you can select those. And then recurring billing, if it's one time, if it's recurring, if it's a dollar trial. Filtering by dollar trial can be great because you can actually find some very high converting and with some decent payouts too. Like sometimes a dollar trial is gonna have like an average commission of, let's see, yeah, right, $48, $31, $22, $106, wow. I imagine they have a free trial version and that, but most of their sales are coming from something else if they have that high of a average cart. But just an example that you can try to start to drill down to some low ticket but still high paying offers with the dollar trial filter there. Another great one, if you know you just like to work fast and copy, paste, kind of swipe files and things like that, checking that they must have an affiliate tools page is a great way to kind of filter past the people who maybe aren't as savvy and aren't offering things as much. Must have vendor spotlight. The vendor spotlight is, let's see, what's this thing right here, right, with Back to Life. It's basically just more details built into ClickBank's ecosystem than going to their affiliate page. And then recently promoted, that's if you, the user, have recently promoted an offer. This is a test account. I haven't promoted any offers, so nothing would pop up if I checked that. But if you just wanted to see offers in the marketplace of ones you have promoted, you could check that. And then affiliates require approval. This would show anyone that whitelists or kind of like uses commission groupings to approve affiliates. So not all affiliates are wide open, right? So now I'm seeing Back to Life, Toxiburn, The Lost Ways, Organifi. All of these people I'll have to go to their affiliate page and apply through them to get access to these. A lot of people like to filter by this because if they're being more exclusive with affiliates, it might mean more friction for me to get promoting them, but there might be less competition with those offers. They might be a higher quality, they might be more branded, right? Those kinds of things. So it's worth checking out and kind of playing with this a bit. And then of course you can drill into any of the categories and kind of check out these same types of things to drill down and get more specific to the niche you're operating within. But that is in a nutshell the best way to kind of like navigate and how to kind of tweak these filters and attributes and different parts of the marketplace to find the best types of offers for your traffic and to promote or what you might need on an earning basis. So to recap everybody, you've got the ClickBank marketplace. It's where affiliates go to find offers to promote. Now you know how to use it, how you can filter down to find the top paying offers if you need those, less competitive offers if you need that, different ways to manipulate what the marketplace is showing you to drill down and find the best offers for you to promote. I would love to hear what you learned in this video. There's honestly things that I went to prep for this that I didn't realize the marketplace did, and I've worked at ClickBank for over 5 years now. So I was a little embarrassed with that, but there's some little hidden features that you could be using to improve that and find the best offers. Let me know in the comments below how you're gonna be leveraging this and what kind of things you like to do in the marketplace, how you like to filter it by. And please like and subscribe so you get new videos from us every week. Cheers, happy scanning.